We are 7 right now. Okay, let's wait for the others. Cesar.
Hi, teacher.
Hello. We have Cesar, we have Magdia. They are very happy. Okay. All right. Excellent. We are 10 people. We're missing 7 people. Los que estaban conectados, pero no estaban presentes. Okay. Well, no problem. Let's go and make the groups. Let me see who's here. We are 9 people, okay? Ana Marcela, Carlitos Pérez, César Moreno, Fanny, Jonathan, Magdiel, Marcela Melgar, Raúl, Sandre, Sandrita. Well, we say only those. Okay. Yeah. The others didn't connect. No problem. It's okay. Let's go to the groups. My friends, let's go to the groups. I'm going to make 3 groups. Solo 3 grupitos, okay?
Teacher, ¿qué vamos a practicar?
Vamos a practicar pages 16, 17, and 18. Hasta aquí. Okay. This is,
okay. No se ve la pantalla.
Supuestamente I'm sharing. No estoy sharing. Qué chavacán. Sorry. Okay. So here we go. We're going to practice this. The instructions say, make sentences using there is and there are. This is page 17. Now you're going to practice this, okay, but later we're going to work on this. First, practice this part. In looking at this, we're going to decide if these are true or false. True or false. Ok, vamos a ver al mapa y vamos a decir si esto es cierto o verdad, falso o verdadero. Ok, this, by looking at the map. Ok. And only. Solo estas dos cositas van a ser. Sentences and true or false. There is a shopping mall. There is a shopping mall on First Avenue. Let's see. First Avenue. Ta-da, ta-da. First Avenue. Shopping mall?
True. Yeah,
it's true. Okay. Yes, that's what you have to do. So let's go to the groups. Now we are 11. So 3 groups. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Groups are beginning. Practice with your partners. Page 17, 18, 19.
¿Tiene usted disponible, Carlos?
Sí, teacher, nos da chance para compartir. ¿Ya ven?
Yes.
Okay. Sí.
There is a gym my neighborhood.
O podría ser in my neighborhood. Teacher. Yes.
Yes, there is a gym in my neighborhood. Me comí el in.
Okay.
So, para que vean que todos cometemos errores.
Okay. There is a gym in my neighborhood.
In my neighborhood. Yes. Mm-hmm.
There are many restaurants in my neighborhood.
Cuando usemos many, pongámosle la S. There are many restaurants.
Okay.
There are many churches. There are many schools. Okay.
There are many restaurants in my neighborhood.
Okay.
Otro.
There is a bookstore in my neighborhood. There is many cafeterias in my neighborhood.
There is a drugstore in my neighborhood.
Diga una en plural también.
There are two supermarkets in my neighborhood.
Many. There are many or some.
Okay, there is a barber.
Yo porque hoy no tengo acceso a la compu en el teléfono, no sé por qué me cuesta.
Ajá, es que yo estoy compartiendo el teléfono y me sale que estoy compartiendo.
Sí, me parece.
Ahí está.
Andamos perdidas.
Okay, you have to make sentences. Okay, say like this. Piensen en su vecindario, in my neighborhood. Y pregúntense cuántas de estas cosas hay. Solo es una, using there is. Y aquí pongo in porque me comí el in. There is a church. There is a church in my neighborhood. No, teacher, hay varias iglesias. Oh,
there are some churches.
There are some churches in my neighborhood.
Okay, entonces sí es como dependiendo si son plural. O sea, todas estas se pueden utilizar en singular y en plural. Lo único que nosotros tenemos que hacer es identificar si hay varias o hay una.
Exactly, in your neighborhood.
Okay. Uh-huh. Okay.
Aquí me comí el in para ratificar que todos cometemos error. In my neighborhood.
¿Y si no hay?
Perdón. Si no hay.
Sí, sí.
Si no hay. There isn't. There isn't a bookstore in my neighborhood. Sí.
Teacher, yo no entiendo muy bien cuándo vamos a usar there are. There are.
Sí, vale. There is es singular, there are es plural.
Uh-huh.
¿Cuándo es plural? Cuando son más de dos. Singular, una. Plural, dos, tres, cuatro o más. Y entonces usted dice, in my neighborhood. One, two, three. There are three. There are three bookstores in my neighborhood.
Ok, ya entendí.
Ah, ok, universities. One university. There is a university.
There is a university.
University? No. No
university. ¿Qué significa a few?
A few, unos poquitos.
Poquitos.
Unos poquitos. Si decimos, no, no hay universidad en mi neighborhood. Ok. There isn't a university in my neighborhood. There isn't a university in my neighborhood. Factory. Teacher, what is factory? What is factory?
Factory, como tienda de...
Fábrica.
Ah.
And you say, the fábrica, no, no, in my neighborhood, no. Then you say...
There isn't.
A factory, there isn't a factory in my neighborhood. Okay?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Muchas gracias.
Thanks, teacher.
No problem, my friend. No problem.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay.
My entonces sería they are two schools in my neighborhood. En la de abajo, si la pusiéramos en plural.
My friends, aquí si ustedes se fijan es
hello, teacher.
In my neighborhood, ¿verdad? Aquí es in my neighborhood. Entonces ustedes fíjense en su propio vecindario. Hay uno, digan there is a. Si hay tres, cuatro, cinco, y si quieren poner el número aquí, está bien. Si no usan a few, unos poquitos, son algunos, a lot of, muchos. A lot of se dice many, several, or a lot of. Entonces, pueden decir bookstore, only one. It's a bookstore in my neighborhood. Y le ponen in porque me lo comí. It's a bookstore in my neighborhood. And shoe stores, like seven shoe stores. So there are many bookstores, no, sorry, shoe stores. There are many shoe stores in my neighborhood. Adob, pardos, 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 adob.
Ni shoes.
Y shoes.
La tienda libre.
Okay. Yes, exacto.
Ok. Entonces, por aras de tiempo, compañeros, creo que hagamos dos cada uno, dos oraciones, una en singular, una en plural, y pasamos a la otra porque ya nos tardamos un poquito.
Sure, go ahead, go ahead. Ah, otra cosa. Si no hay, there isn't. University. There isn't a university in my neighborhood. There isn't. There is a barbershop. No, there aren't any barbershops. Con negativo usamos any. Any. There aren't any barbershops in my neighborhood.
Okay, teacher.
Yes, no problem.
Okay, empiezo yo. There is a gym.
Bookstore false.
It's false.
There is a bookstore across from the city hall. False.
It's false.
False.
There is a pupuseria between the city hall and the church.
False.
False.
It's false.
There are two stores in this neighborhood. Two stores.
It's false.
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 There isn't
a shoe store my neighborhood.
Shoe store.
Zapatería. They are
no.
One, two.
No, there are.
Hay más de uno.
Uno.
Entonces, si solo hay uno, es there is.
There is. Sí, tienes razón. There is a supermarket my neighborhood.
Neighborhood. ¿Se acuerdan de Robin Hood?
Good.
Neighborhood. Bien, no sé si va usted, Fanny, o yo.
La segunda, ¿verdad? Con la de la segunda fila.
Sí, la segunda columna.
There is a church my neighborhood.
There is a church.
There are four schools in my neighborhood. There is some hotel. Para decir que no hay hotel.
There isn't a hotel.
My name sería there isn't my hotel my neighborhood
in my neighborhood y el in, ¿verdad? Entonces no se lo coman ustedes también.
Okay.
In my
there are five bakery in my neighborhood. There are 10 restaurants in my neighborhood. There are five barbershop in my neighborhood. Así sería. Ya puedo. Next.
Solo no olvidemos la S al final. Bakeries, barbershop.
Bakery.
Yes. Okay. Excellent. Very good.
Thanks.
Okay, boy. There are a few There are a few gym. No, ¿cómo sería después de pronunciar el quantifier? ¿Qué se dice después, Lee?
Now. There are a few churches, there are a few schools.
Ah, okay, el lugar.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Noun y después el neighborhood, ya el place ya se lo di.
Eso se lo tengo que quitar.
No, eso está bien, déjense.
No. Perdón, vaya, digamos, there are
a few.
There are a few. ¿Qué sigue después?
Churches.
Ok, entonces esta palabra sería después.
Gyms.
Ok, entonces there are a few gyms in my neighborhood.
Gyms.
Gyms. Gyms. Gyms in my neighborhood. Ok, there isn't a hospital in my neighborhood. There isn't a cinema in my neighborhood. There are university. No, there is a university in my neighborhood. There are some shopping mall in my neighborhood. There are many factory in my neighborhood.
Factories.
Factories.
There are many factories in my
neighborhood. There are many factories in my neighborhood. Okay.
Pasamos a la siguiente.
Exactly. True or false?
Aquí.
La siguiente pantalla.
Ah, sí.
Uh-huh. Hay que contestar, ¿no? De acuerdo a la imagen.
Ok.
Para que la podamos ver, la debería de bajar más y solo dejar como la última dos para ver un poquito la de arriba y un poquito la de abajo.
Ok. Así.
Sí.
O leemos la...
Si leamos la pregunta,
ajá, o sea, nos vamos al cuadrito.
There is a shopping mall on First Avenue.
Vamos a ver dónde está el mall.
True.
First Avenue.
Porque está sobre, o sea, en First Avenue.
Mm-hmm.
There is a church across from the shopping mall.
Está frente al shopping mall.
Uh-huh.
Vamos a ver.
La iglesia, sure.
No.
Falco. Shopping mall, ¿dónde está?
Abajo.
El mall.
Ahí está.
No, quizás el mall. Ajá, el mall ha de ser. Es falso. Falso.
False.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
There is a church on the corner of First Avenue and Barrios Strip.
Corner.
On the corner. Es como.
¿Cómo es? ¿Qué es corner?
Ahorita aquí lo creo que lo apunté en la on the corner.
Esquina.
Yo también.
Esquina.
En la esquina entre First Avenue y Barrios Strip.
True.
Ok, entonces
Sí.
Barrios Strip y...
Sí. Pero
¿dónde está el otro? First Avenue.
Está ahí.
No, porque la iglesia está de este lado. Y esta es esta esquina y sería esta es otra esquina. Falso.
Está en la Avenue. Y la...
Banco en la calle Barrios.
Uh-huh.
El banco, no, está en la primera avenida. Ah, ¿cómo no? Sí, sí, está ahí.
Yes.
Aquí está. Uh-huh.
Entonces, esa es cierta.
Pero...
There is a bookstore on First Avenue.
There's a bookstore. There is a bookstore on First Avenue. Si hay una tienda de libros o una librería, ¿no? Pues yo creo que es falso porque está abajo, a mano derecha. Se está sobre la avenida, sobre la calle Roosevelt, no sobre la primera avenida.
Ok. La 7, ¿verdad? Solo que no.
Sí, no se preocupe. Vamos por la 9, entonces.
La 9, así.
La 8. No, la 8.
La 8.
There is a bookstore across from the city.
City Hall.
¿Qué es el city?
Sí, es cierto, entonces. It's true.
Yes.
There is
a pupusería between a city hall and the church. Si está en medio del City Hall y de la iglesia.
La pupusería.
Uh-huh.
City Hall. No sé.
Es falso porque ahí no dice que hay ninguna pupusería. Hay una calle.
Uh-huh.
O un callejón, no sé. Un callejón sería.
Solo que en el restaurante.
Podría ser también. Two store.
There are two store. In the
neighbor.
Que hay dos tiendas, dice en mi vecindario.
School Palace and Book World.
Es falso, verdadero. ¿Dónde está?
Es falso, creo yo.
El Sport Palace y el Book World no creen que se entienda.
¿Y el mall también? No.
No sé. Sí, no es tienda, pero ahí hay un montón de tiendas. Porque el mall es como el metro centro aquí.
Teacher, ¿esa la última se refería a nuestro vecindario o al esquema que estaba presentando ahí?
Al que les... Lo único que ustedes pueden hacerle referencia es este, porque cada uno tiene su propio vecindario, no sabrían qué es cierto y qué no es cierto. Y en su vecindario no había First Avenue, ni Barrio Street, ni Roosevelt. Y estos son específicos.
Ok, teacher. Ah, pues yo considero que es falso porque no habla de ningún store ahí.
Bueno.
Finish, no.
Sí.
Yes.
Finish. Yes.
Okay, my friends.
Hello, teacher.
Let's see. Let's check. The last one. Use the map to answer the questions below. Which street is the restaurant on? Restaurant. No avenue, but street. What's which street?
Roosevelt Street.
Roosevelt. He's on Roosevelt. Mm-hmm. Roosevelt Street. Okay. Which street is the City Hall on? City Hall. Roosevelt.
Roosevelt or Second Avenue.
Yeah, but this is an avenue. Unless they want to say avenue.
What sí, avenue? Estoy hablando de calle.
Street. Mm-hmm. So, the Roosevelt. And the last one. Which street is the park on? Park. On Barrios and on
Barrios, Roosevelt.
In between.
Between. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So finished. All right. Let's call roll. No, we're missing still. Okay. Let's see. Bank. There is a bank on Barrios Street. There is a bank on the corner of First Avenue and Barrio Street. There is a sports palace on Barrio Street. There is a restaurant on First Avenue or on Roosevelt.
Click donde dejó la pupusería.
Uh-huh. I invented the pupusería. There is no pupusería. Yeah, we need the pupusería because it's something that is ours.
Quitemos el restaurante y pongamos la pupusería ahí.
Excellent. Yes. Good idea.
En el parque está la pupusería.
Okay, let's put the pupusería here. Okay, pupusería here. Soccer field. A soccer field here. Soccer field and the pupuseria. They eat and then play soccer. Okay. So, okay, my friend, let's check who's present and who isn't. No, but it's better like this because I can see you better. Ana Marcela Argueta.
Present, teacher.
Excellent. Andrea Sofía Benítez.
Present, teacher.
Excellent. Nice. Carlos Ernesto López. No,
Carlos teacher.
López, sorry. I'm changing.
Present. Your... Present, teacher.
Yeah, nice. Carlos Manuel Hernández. Carol, you come. César Quimides Moreno.
Present, teacher.
Excellent, nice. Elías Adalberto Aguilar. Eric Giovanni Hueso. Evelyn didn't come. Fanny Judith Palacios.
Present, teacher, good night.
Right. Flor Elizabeth.
Sorry, present, teacher, Eric Giovanni. Se me trabó esta máquina, perdón.
Don't worry. It's okay. So it's okay, no problem. Let's see. So Flor Elizabeth, Jonathan Mauricio Galvez.
Present.
Excellent, nice. Magdiel Esaú García.
Present, teacher.
Excellent, very good. Marcela Karina Melgar.
Present, teacher.
Excellent, very good. Today, Raúl stays with me, right? Raúl.
Okay, teacher.
Yes. So, Raúl, present.
Present.
Reinaldo Antonio Fernández.
Present, teacher.
Excellent, nice. Sandra Yanira Ayala, Sandrita.
Present, teacher.
Excellent, nice. Walter didn't come. So, Christian didn't come. Okay. Giovanni Edgardo Marroquín. Okay. So, my friends. Ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for attending tonight. We stop here. We continue tomorrow. Okay? Continue tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, sleep well. See you tomorrow.
Hey, teacher.
Good night, teacher.
Good night, teacher.
Bye-bye.
Good night. Take care. Be good.
Peace and love.
Bye, teacher. Good night, my friend.
Peace and love, right? Yeah, be good. Behave.
Bye-bye.
Good night. Good night. Take care. Okay. Raul, hello, my friend. Good evening.
Hello, teacher.
How can I help you?
Which is the meaning of there are and there is?
There is and there are. Los dos significan hay.
Hay.
Hay de haber.
Uh-huh.
Hay de haber. So,
the difference is one is singular and one is plural.
Yes, there is singular. There are is plural. Uh-huh. Yes.
Okay.
Uh-huh. You're right. Singular, there is. There is a cafeteria, pero los dos significan hay.
Hay, okay. Y uh-huh. Se puede ocupar para cualquier objeto.
Sí, si es contable y singular, there is a book on the table.
Uh-huh.
Es algo que no se puede contar, como por ejemplo, milk, cream, cheese. Entonces se dice, no se puede decir, how can I say? Let me see. Decimos, there is milk, o there is some milk.
In the mm-hmm.
No decimos, there is a milk, porque como no se puede contar, ¿verdad?
Entonces, correcto.
Decimos, there is some milk in the refrigerator.
Mm-hmm. Sí, porque como no se pueden contar, por eso tienen unidades de medida diferentes.
Exacto. Uh-huh. Es el, uh-huh. Si es plural, decimos para plural nosotros tenemos que hablar acerca de there are y el número de el número del objeto. You say, ¿cuál es el número del objeto? Si hay dos tiendas, there are two stores in the corner, or there are two stores in my neighborhood. Supermarkets, there is a supermarket in my neighborhood. Many, there are a lot of shoe stores in my neighborhood. Okay, así es, there is, there are. En español no hay diferencia, se dice
hay bastante, hay poquito.
There are, sí, no hay there is, no hay there are, sino que solo un hay.
Correcto.
Exacto. Esa es la idea. ¿Una otra preguntita, my friend?
Quiero ver. Leí lo normal, va. Que lleva el nombre, en el caso si hay cantidad es la cantidad, y luego refiriéndose a qué, por sí. Dónde se encuentra.
There is a noun place. Si es plural, there are la cantidad, el noun y el place.
There are
a few stores in my neighborhood. There are some bookstores in the neighborhood. There are many parks in my neighborhood. En mi caso yo digo, there are many pupuserías in my neighborhood.
Tiene poquito.
There are many, there are like 8 pupuserías in my neighborhood. So there are many pupuserías in my neighborhood.
Okay, only 8.
Only 8. Yeah. In your neighborhood?
It's maybe 25.
Maybe 20 or 21 pupuserías. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Or more. But...
Or more. No, in my neighborhood, there are like about 8.
Okay. 1 or 2 pupuserías in a corner of.
In the same corner. Yes.
Yeah, in the same corner.
Yes, there are, let me see. 1, 2, 3 in the same place. 3 pupuserías.
Yeah.
One that is called pupusería Emmanuel. And the other is pupusería Daniel. The other is pupusería Desayunos. I don't remember, but something like this. And then
the pupusería Manuel is your
no, I don't have a pupusería. No. There is one a kiosk sin nombre.
Oh.
Otra sin nombre.
Por oh, okay.
Dos sin nombre. Y una ahí abajo sin nombre. Y al otro sí hay otra que es, no me acuerdo cómo, I don't remember the name, I forget.
Aquí hay una que se llama los cucarachos.
La cucaracha, wow.
Es que es el sobrenombre de los dueños. El cucaracho le quedó. La cucaracha.
So let's go to la cucaracha. They say, no. Yeah. Okay. Yes.
That's bueno, cool. Esa era mi duda.
Ok, entonces lo dejo, my friend, para que vaya a hacer la tarea.
Okay. Bueno, gracias.
Yes.
Thanks, teacher.
Welcome, my friend. Have a good night. Take care. Be good,
thanks.
Take care. I'll see you tomorrow, right?
Good night. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, my friend. All right.